Little Bear's Little Boat by Eve Bunting, illustrated by Nancy Carpenter and read by Nathan. Little Bear loved his little boat. He rode it all around Huckleberry Lake. He fished from it. On sunny days, he lay back in it, closed his eyes and dreamed, and he was happy. When his mother called him in for bed, he pulled his little boat up to the shore. "Good night, little boat," he said. "I'll see you tomorrow," and he always did. But then something happened. Little Bear began to grow and grow. He got bigger and bigger. Soon he wasn't a little bear anymore. He was a big bear, and he didn't fit in his little boat. He tried to sit in it as it bobbed on the lake, but he and the little boat both sank down, down to the bottom of the blue, blue water. "Where are you, my big bear?" Mother called. Big Bear and his little boat both spluttered up. "Glug," Big Bear said. "You are too big a bear now to fit in that little boat," Mother said. "It is the little bear's destiny to grow and grow till he is a big bear. It is the little boat's destiny to stay the same size." Big Bear was sad. "I can't leave my little boat with no bear to sit in it, or fish from it, or dream in it," he said. "It is the little boat's destiny to keep sailing on a blue, blue lake." He scratched his head. "I know, I will find another little bear who will love my little boat the way I love it." Big Bear walked around Huckleberry Lake. "Have you seen any little bears anywhere?" he asked Beaver. "Not since you were a little bear yourself," Beaver said. Otter hadn't seen a little bear either. But Blue Heron had. "One lives with his mother on the other side of the lake," he said. "I saw him eating berries this very morning." So Big Bear walked around the lake again and found the little bear. "I have a little boat for you," Big Bear said. "But there is one thing you should know. You will get bigger and bigger till you are a big bear. That is the little bear's destiny." The little bear listened carefully. "The little boat will stay the same size because that is its destiny. When that happens, you must find another little bear to fit in the little boat, because it is also a little boat's destiny to keep sailing on a blue, blue lake. Will you promise?" "I promise," the little bear said. All summer long, Big Bear saw the little bear rowing the little boat around Huckleberry Lake and fishing from it. And on sunny days, Big Bear would stop what he was doing and watch the little bear as he lay back in the little boat dreaming. Big Bear could tell that the little bear was happy. Big Bear was happy too. Thank you for listening. I will read another story again very soon. Goodbye.